crazy.
Thank you.
Kill them!
Hey.
sweet. Nice. Let's go. Looking for Diamond City? Just follow the signs.
What do you mean you can't open the gate? Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. You. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before Danny catches on with the bluff.
You first.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrapped for parts.
Mr. McDonough, tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatening to throw free speech in the dumpster.
This really isn't any of my business.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, miss. No. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
Whatever. I'm not gonna be here long.
Another see-no-evil type. You'll fit in just fine with all the inept guards.
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
Not really your business.
Well, whatever you do, don't bother going to Diamond City Security for help.
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. Hmm, a big Diamond City welcome from the mayor. You feel honored yet? Look, I gotta go get settled in, but, stop by my office later. I have an idea for an article you'd be perfect for.
You're Sullivan, right?
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again. Am I right?
I wasn't lying. I got a whole supply train coming in tomorrow.
Oh, of course you do. Now tell me the one about you and the fish that got away. Hey, what's brought you into town anyway? Be good to note it down in the logs.
Not really your business.
All right. Sorry I asked.
Hey, kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper? Extra, extra! Is your neighbor really human? We have the exclusive! Free paper to newcomers. If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
The Institute?
You ain't heard of the Institute, lady? They snatch people up in the night, and no one hears from them again. It's all in the paper. Better read up before they grab you, too.
Who's gone missing?
Drifters, residents, stadium seats. So you better be careful, newcomer.
I believe you.
You're a real lost lamb in the wolf. So what are you doing in Diamond City, anyway?
I came here looking for someone.
Let me guess. That someone's gone missing, right? That's what I'm telling you. So who is it?
I'm looking for my baby. His name's Sean.
You have a son, lady? Wow, you're old. You're in bad luck. No one tries to find missing people in Diamond City. And no one's going to want to get there.
You're a smart kid. Isn't there someone in town who isn't afraid of this Institute?
Well, there is the detective, Mr. Nick Valentine. He's not afraid of anything.
What else do you know about Mr. Valentine?
I know all the adults who go...
Is that all you got, kid?
Hey, I already gave you...
Ramen meat on the hooks.
Anyone is one of those things. It's that secretary of his, her and her perfect.
Hey, there's a bar in the old theater district that's paraders only. Combat zone.
Swatter, 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 swatter. No human hair.
That's just
don't
it,
walk outside
Johnny,
the wall undefended.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes. It's all he understands.
Yes?
You? I don't know you. Just keep your distance.
Why?
Because I don't know you, and I will not serve a synth pretending to be human. So are you human?
Synth? What's a synth?
A synth, as in synthetic person. Those things the Institute makes. Look real, with hair and sweat and blood and... everything. So, are you human or not?
human as the day I was born.
Well, you do look human enough. But I'll be watching you. I have eyes like a... Well, they're good eyes. Got it? All right. We can do business, but no funny stuff.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Here's what we got.
Don't. Be caught dead! Protection from Commonwealth weaponry!
Buy and sell everything, to everyone, except synths. No synths allowed here.
Win the game! Buy a squatter!
Hey, you're the new girl, right?
The new girl?
Word kinda travels fast in Diamond City. What can I say? Name's Arturo Rodriguez. If you need protection, let's talk.
So you know weapons, huh?
Listen, I can sell you guns, swords, whatever. And they'll keep you alive for sure. But the real secret is in the mods. The little personal touches. Install a scope, expand the clip size, whatever. You spend time with your gear, and you'll have the right answer to every problem. Anyway, let's get back to you and what kind of protection you need.
Not today.
Another time, then.
So thirsty. Doctor says I can't drink liquor no more. Cola. Need a new Coca-Cola.
Word is something bad went down in the old museum of witchcraft.
Sheffield.
Up near Cola. Salem.
New Coca-Cola.
Why would anyone even go there? Abandoned forever.
Here you go.
Ah, thank you. Thank you.
You need a genuine, authentic, custom-made hickory swatter.
Not looking to buy right now.
Fine. Get going.
Thank you. It's like I can finally think straight.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
Really? You mean it?
just don't turn into some damn...
I won't. I mean, I might take a few bottles with me, but that's all.
We got small arms, long arms, ammunition.
Newcomer, huh? Talk to Abbott at the wall.
Sometimes you gotta
wonder, does anyone fight back? Changer.
Institute has to have enemies, right?
What? You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale, man. They don't exist.
Nah, I heard from my cousin. He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code phrase and everything. Follow the Freedom Trail.
The hell is that supposed to mean? You're full of it. That kind of talk is gonna get you snatched up by the synths.
You read the paper? Damn synths. Hiding among us.
Shop in safety. No synths allowed at the
door. Your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, Liz. It's important.
You're right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude, but it's just... the detective... he's gone missing.
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Hey, I'd love to help, but there's the small matter of expenses.
Money, huh? I do have 125 caps in the old rainy day fund.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits.
Uh-huh. I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
The Institute? I ain't scared of them. No, really. I swear.
Thank you.
Hey there.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
Welcome to the best tire store in the Commonwealth.
Hey.
Let's see how we can make you look badass today.
What kinds of things do you sell?
Clothes I mashed up, combined, scavenged, and made look amazing. I also have a schematic for a custom clothing workbench, and some notes about armor designs, if you're interested. And I specialize in vault suit modifications.
Let's see what you've got.
Yeah, we really need to get you out of that. Don't even bother.
Sweet.
Loctite. Excellent. Yes.
think?
Yeah, you're probably right. Gotta cut down on the jet, I guess.
That'll start talking crazy.
Huh? What? What the fuck?
What happened?
Time's up.
What the?
Fucking hide from me? Dead.
On the other side.
This is bullshit. Hiding from me? Not even possible. Gotcha! Or not.
Now you're here. Just die!
Come on, fight!
There.
Everything's starting to sound like footsteps these days.
Just like a little bitch.